horror films like The Clown Murders or thrillers like The Silent Partner. Stress and anxiety allegedly followed Candy throughout his personal and professional life, while his weight also fluctuated based on the actor's tendency to binge eat in response to these stressors.
Now, but here you got a little bit of a dilemma there. We got a crisis ourselves. Allow me to introduce myself. Gus Polinski. Both the King of the Midwest.
John Candy's death from a fatal heart attack on March 4th, 1994 left a huge hole in the hearts of his fans, friends, and family. He was a truly unique talent. Number 18. Corey Haim. The legacy of Corey Haim shouldn't solely be as a cautionary tale for child actors, but it's also important to recognize how early success was detrimental to the young man's life. Haim was a great actor, who perhaps never got to achieve his full potential despite standout performances in The Lost Boys, Lucas, and Silver Bullet.
This is for the good guys.
Corey was in and out of rehab over a dozen times throughout his life, and had a contentious relationship with his frequent partner in cinematic crime, Corey Feldman.
Get on. I'll drive you home.
No way, man. Look, I have a driver's exam to take Saturday. I don't want to get killed. Les, your license is just as important to me as it is to you. I'll take it easy.
Haim also claimed he was a victim of abuse as a younger actor. Corey died on March 10th, 2010, the result of multiple factors, including pneumonia. Number 17, Naya Rivera. There have been a number of high-profile deaths behind the scenes of the Fox series Glee. Naya Rivera was a member of this tragic club, a young actress whose death came as a true shock to her fans. Rivera worked as an actor, musician, and activist over the course of her life, and enjoyed a career that started way back at the tender age of 4. Naya was also a mother, a fact that made her loss all the more tragic. Her body was recovered from Lake Piru, California on July 13th, 2020, after drowning 5 days before while swimming with her son.
Naya and her 4-year-old son Josie were alone that fateful day. That apparently made the difference between life and death.
Number 16, Cameron Boyce. Cameron Boyce didn't let epilepsy slow down his red-hot career as a Disney Channel star. The young actor appeared on shows like Jesse and in the Descendants franchise after cutting his teeth as a child actor on films like the 2008 horror flick Mirrors.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
Okay, well, you gotta get going, alright?
Okay.
Boyce would continue to work for the Disney brand, taking lead roles on shows like Jake and the Neverland Pirates. Boyce died in his sleep on July 6th, 2019, as a result of a seizure that occurred over the course of the night. He was only 20 years old.
Somewhere between the last text he sent me in the morning, he was gone. It's not cliche to say, you never know.
Number 15, Jane Mansfield. The life of Hollywood bombshell Jane Mansfield was many things, but it was never boring.
I'm so happy. I knew it. I knew that this time it just had to be. It had to be true. Oh, Jeff, I'm so happy for him, darling.
The sex symbol of the silver screen was associated with the Church of Satan, did the first nude scene of the modern post-silent film era, and was never far from the headlines or her legions of admirers. Mansfield was also an early Playboy playmate, appearing multiple times throughout the late 1950s and into the 60s.
I'm just going to New York with my secretary to rest in seclusion. Seclusion, is that right?
That's right. Means you want to be alone.
Seclusion sounds so dirty.
Well, it isn't.
Mariska Hargitay's mom was an icon in life, but her death was tragic in equal measure. Jane Mansfield was killed on June 29th, 1967, along with her driver and attorney, after the car they were in collided with a tractor trailer. Three of her children, including Mariska, were asleep in the back seat and survived with minor injuries. Number 14, Jonathan Brandis. It's difficult to know what's going on in someone's life, what they're going through, and how to help. This applies to celebrities just as much as the rest of us, but we as fans rarely have any insight behind the Hollywood curtain.
Thanks for painting that picture for us. Also, I hate to break up this little seminar, but I gotta go.
Jonathan Brandis was a teen heartthrob, sure, but he was also a talented young actor. His work on television, Sequest DSV, was particularly popular, as was his performance as Bill Denbrough in the 1990 iteration of Stephen King's It.
You killed my brother George, you bastard! Let's see you now.
Fear.
Let's see you now.
Done.
He's scared of us, you know? I can feel that. I swear to God, I can.
Unfortunately, Brandis's career was in something of a slump around the early 2000s, and he descended into heavy drinking. The actor would ultimately take his own life in November 2003. Number 13, Robin Williams. The saying, "This one hurts," doesn't even begin to describe how fans of Robin Williams felt when the comic legend left this world on August 11th, 2014. The man's resume speaks for itself. From his humble origins on Mork and Mindy to breakout career-defining roles on Good Will Hunting, Mrs. Doubtfire, The Birdcage, and Jumanji.
They think monkeys, mosquitoes, and lions are bad. That's just the beginning. I've seen things you've only seen in your nightmares.
Elsewhere, Williams' stand-up work and his voice acting on classics like Aladdin endeared more fans around the world.
Excuse
me? Are you looking at me? Did you rub my lamp? Did you wake me up? Did you bring me here? And all of a sudden you're walking out on me? I don't think so.
Bye-bye, Banquet, David, you're gone!
...to entertain and influence millions around the world. Number 12, Anton Yelchin. To discuss the loss of Anton Yelchin is to mourn what might have been. This is because the career of this promising actor seemed to be just hitting its stride before it was horribly cut short by a tragic accident. Yelchin had earned rave reviews for his ability to vacillate between blockbuster features like the Star Trek reboots and darker indie fare such as 2015's nail-biting thriller Green Room.
He's on! But he's gonna wait too!
Anton could seemingly do it all, and fans can only wonder what the actor might have achieved on future projects. Yelchin was tragically crushed by his Jeep Grand Cherokee on June 19th, 2016, while checking his mail.
Police tell ABC News Yelchin got out of his 2015 Jeep Grand Cherokee while pulling out of his steep driveway, the vehicle apparently rolling back.
I didn't see
this gate.
A wrongful death lawsuit was filed against Fiat Chrysler by Anton's parents after his death, and was settled out of court. Number 11. Brittany Murphy. Brittany Murphy had a lot going for her before her untimely death on December 20th, 2009. She had broken out with some varied and engaging work after first making a name for herself with the 90s teen flick Clueless.
You don't think that we mesh well. And it's like, why am I even listening to you to begin with? You're a virgin who can't drive.
Murphy proved she could handle dramas like Girl
I'm ready, Mama!
Films and thrillers like Cherry Falls and Don't Say a Word. The actress even managed to escape the world of rom-coms unscathed with Just Married, proving her versatility and dedication to her craft.
I'm ready!
Her death was shrouded in controversy, however, with disputes as to the actual nature of her demise contrasting the official record of pneumonia. Number 10, Paul Walker. The Fast and Furious franchise may have continued on after the untimely death of its star, Paul Walker, but it never forgot the legacy Walker lent to those early entries.
Brian Earl Spoon. Sounds like a serial killer name. Is that what you are?
No, man.
Don't come around here again.
Hey, man, you know this is bullshit.
Walker's movie star, Good Looks, talent that worked well within big-budget action movie parameters. The man's presence loomed large not only in the Fast and Furious movies, but also in more underrated roles, such as Walker's work in the 2006 film Running Scared.
All right, Nick, listen to me. I want you to think really hard about what your friend might be right now, because the others are looking for him, and if they find him first, I'm gonna
find the gun.
What did you say?
Sadly, the world never got to see what Paul Walker might have done on future projects, as the actor was involved in a fatal car accident on November 30th, 2013. Number 9, Sharon Tate. It's unfair to associate the legacy of Sharon Tate solely with that of the Manson family. This is not only due to the horrible crimes with which Manson and his gang were associated, but also Tate herself, who shone on the silver screen like the brightest burning star.
I'm not disturbing you, am I?
Not at all, not at all.
I just don't know what to do with myself. I get so bored. You can't imagine how bored I get.
The actress's beauty was undeniable, but it didn't define her, and Sharon Tate was equally adept at comedy, as well as performances that required her to do her own stunts. She even trained with the legendary Bruce Lee while working on the spy picture The Wrecking Crew.
Is he home?
Roots.